small town outside of Sacramento called El Dorado Hills.
We really started singing when we were really little.
Our mom is a classical pianist, so she taught us how to play piano and harmonize.
Church choir is the first like experience of singing in front of people, really, and then musical theater, and then gigs. We did
church festivals,
the California State Fair,
just kind of whatever we could get around our small town.
We would sing the national anthem at a lot of different places. The national anthem really opened a lot of doors for us. We did a lot of performing before we went on YouTube, like several years, and we were our own roadies. Like, we were playing the instruments. It was really humbling.
In 2009, we really wanted to get our music out there. We'd been playing together as a band for a really long time, but we wanted a way to connect with our fans. So I had the idea to record a cover of us singing Party in the USA by Miley Cyrus.
Yeah! It's a party in the USA!
We threw it together in like a few days, and we just like did it really fast and knocked it out, and I edited it that night. We put it up the next day, and then it blew up.
We were like, we're onto something. So then we just kept putting them up pretty continuously over the next few years and just started slowly building our YouTube channel. In 2011, then I wrote a poem about a boy that I had a crush on, and then Christina read it and she was like, this could be a song. And that became our song Million Bucks, and it ended up getting on Sirius XM Hits 1 and 20 on 20, and we were completely freaking out because our song had never been on the radio before.
And it ended up making it into the top 10 countdown. We were so blown away.
At like 6 in the morning, my mom came in our room and she's like, girls, you're not gonna believe this. You got nominated for a Teen Choice Award. We were all like, ah.
And then we actually went. It was really fun. We got to walk the red carpet and meet a bunch of fans.
The fan reaction we've been getting is crazy. Like, people come to our shows from other countries.
We have fans all over the world, all different ages.
It's been a little bit crazy, but it's not like insane yet.
You gave me wings and taught me to fly.
Made in America is really special to us. We love the song so much and feel like it really represents us.
Neon Hitch originally wrote it, the singer.
And we heard it and we were like, this could be our single, you guys. If we like change some words, like put our own spin on it, make it more us.
We decided to rewrite the second verse and a little bit of the first verse and put in the rap section, which is my part.
I pledge allegiance to the home of the brave. Blue jeans, ball caps, and football.
I kind of wanted to give a shout out to all the people in the entire country, and especially people like us who are just in kind of a suburban nowhere town. Kind of an anthem for our generation of kind of being patriotic and proud of this country.
Around my head, blue, white, little bit of red. Live free, like we always said. Oh, whoa. Oh.
Hey, I'm Christina.
I'm Catherine.
I'm Lisa.
I'm Amy.
I'm Lauren.
I'm Danny.
And we're Cimorelli.
We're here on the set of our Made in America music video with our amazing director, Eric White.
Thank you. The concept of the video is capturing the group, capturing these amazing performers, superstar entertainers together. They're a family, they're a group, they're friends, they're best friends. I wanted the world to see like how great they are together.
We co-wrote the song, and we have so much American pride and love America. It really, like, made us who we are living here. So to do a patriotic song means a lot to us. Comes to who we are, small town. We have some shout-outs. Sacramento, our hometown. Jonathan's waking up, and then we're having a barbecue at our house. And then we do all sorts of things, like go on the trampoline. We were in our bedrooms. We were, like, dancing and throwing clothes, and it was, like, kind of like real life. Yeah. So that was fun.
We are getting ready to do the shopping cart race. I don't know whose team I'm on. I think I'm going to be Lisa and I. And we're going to win.
We mix a whole bunch of different styles. We mix dancing, singing, we mix 4th of July, we mix fireworks and sparklers, we mix, I mean, we just encompass everything in one day.
That's a wrap!
All beautiful and very talented sisters whose voices have captured the hearts of millions of fans around the world. So, a band with six girls comes with a lot of components. What role do you guys each play?
I'm the leader.
I'm like the...
The jester.
I'm like the... Okay, I'm jokester. Like the one who like keeps the mood light.
I'll like direct traffic in the studio and like take charge of the smaller projects.
Yeah. When we meet people, Amy talks to them a lot.
Yes.
She's the talker.
I'm She's
the
kind of like our PR, yeah.
And then Lauren is kind of like an assistant to me. She's kind of like my personal assistant, basically.
Yeah, I am.
And then Danny is...
Danny's the youthful energy.
Yeah.
Because we're also old.
We're all so old.
Yeah, so old. In this new social media world, we believe girl power is very, very important, and girls need to stand up for other girls, which is what you guys are doing as sisters.
It's really important to try to stay positive and set a good example because people are listening to what we say.
I want to tell other girls, you can decide that you don't need to take someone else's opinion seriously about yourself. People that actually live with you and see you on a daily basis, those are the people who, besides yourself, are going to have an accurate point of view.
No one can change you except for you.